오늘의 핵심 패턴 보겠습니다. 첫 번째로는 I remember 동사 ing ages ago 하면은 오래전에 뭐뭐 했던 게 기억나요 라는 뜻이고요. 두 번째로 more of a 명사라고 하면 뭐뭐에 더 가까운 이라는 뜻을 갖고 있습니다. 이 두 패턴을 이용해서 함께 만들어 볼 영어 문장의 우리말 번역 먼저 보여드리겠습니다. 네, 영어 문장 확인해 볼까요? 첫 번째 패턴은 I remember 동사 ing ages ago 오래전에 뭐뭐 했던 게 기억나요? 였는데요. 저는 오래전에 이 책을 읽었던 기억이 나요? 라고 말하고 싶으면 I remember reading this book ages ago 하면 됩니다. 큰 소리로 읽어주세요.
Repeat after me. I remember reading this book ages ago. One more time. I remember reading this book ages ago. Great, let's look at our next example.
저는 오래전에 피아노 수업을 들었던 기억이 나요는 영어로 I remember taking piano lessons ages ago. 발음 연습해 볼게요.
I remember taking piano lessons ages ago. One more time. I remember taking piano lessons ages ago. Great, let's look at our next pattern.
More of a 명사, more of a 명사 이렇게 쓰는 형태인데요. 첫 번째로는 그건 뭐 예를 들어 직업이라기보다는 취미에 가까웠어요. 그런 부분이 좀 생략되어 있죠. 의미상으로 들어가 있습니다. That was more of a hobby. That was more of a hobby. 또는 뭐 It was more of a hobby rather than a job. 이런 형태가 될 텐데요. 큰 소리로 읽어주세요.
That was more of a hobby. One more time. That was more of a hobby. Let's move on to our last example.
그는 저에게 동료라기보다는 친구에 가까웠어요. 아니면 남자친구라기보다는 친구에 가까웠어요. 이런 말을 하고 싶을 때 He was more of a friend to me. He was more of a friend to me 하면 됩니다. 같이 읽어볼까요?
He was more of a friend to me. One more time. He was more of a friend to me. Perfect. Let's take a look at Sarah's clip for the last time with both English and Korean subtitles.
So I remember reading something ages ago, and it basically went along the lines of don't make promises when you're in a good mood, and don't make your decisions when you're angry. And I really like this because I know so many people who overpromise when they're in a good mood, and they'll be like, oh yeah, let's meet up and have lunch, and let's do this, and let's do that. And then when the day comes, they cancel because they overpromised because they were so happy at the time. And when they came to a neutral mood, then they were like, ooh, I don't actually want to do that thing. And the same comes to making decisions. Sometimes if you're angry and upset and you make a decision, you can make a rash decision that you wouldn't normally make. And so I think that it's much better to try and wait and do it in more of a level mood rather than trying to rush things and just be like, oh, that's the decision done. So yeah, that's what I try to follow.
오늘의 알쏭달쏭 영어 표현 한마디 소개하겠습니다.
Okay.
네, rash decision이라는 표현 아까 이야기했잖아요.
That's right.
성급하게 결정을 내리려고 하는 사람에게 성급하게 결론 내리지 마세요.
Yes. Don't jump to conclusions. Don't jump to conclusions.
네, 아직 단정하긴 이릅니다. Mm-hmm. 너무 빨리 결정하지 마세요. 그래서 don't jump to conclusions.
Yes. Don't jump to conclusions.
Conclusion이라는 것은 결론을 말하고요. 아, mm-hmm. 이래서 그렇구나 라고 결론 내려버리는 거를
no.
jump해서 그냥 뛰어가는 거예요.
You're just jumping, right? Even if it's not right. Like, don't jump to conclusions.
네. Okay. Wait until you see more evidence.
Yes.
네.
Perfect.
증거나 근거가 더 나올 때까지 기다리자.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Perfect. Let's move on to In the Social World.
기분이 좋을 때 약속을 하는 것에 관련된 소셜미디어 포스팅 두 개 가져왔습니다.
Let's take a look. In my short years on earth, I've learned never to make promises when you're in a good mood. I just remembered that I said I'd paint the garage this weekend. Making promises when you're in a good mood is truly dangerous.
네, 첫 번째 포스팅 카일 씨가 이렇게 썼네요. Mm-hmm. In my short years on earth, 이런 말도 자주 쓰죠.
Yeah.
지구에서 보낸 내 짧은 시간 동안 mm-hmm. 몇 년 안 됐지만
그러니까 They're not that old.
별로 나이가 많진 않지만 uh-huh. 그동안 살아오면서 느낀 건데요. I've learned never to make promises mm-hmm. when you're in a good mood. Mm-hmm. 기분이 좋을 때는 절대로 약속을 하지 않아야 된다는 걸 배웠대요.
Mm-hmm. And 그리고, the next one from Mufang Guashe says
네, it's an interesting name. I just remembered that I said 내가 이렇게 말했다는 걸 이제 막 기억을 한 거예요. Uh-huh. I would paint the garage this weekend. Mm-hmm. 이번 주말에 차고를 페인트 칠하겠다고 mm-hmm. 이야기했던 게 기억이 난 거죠. Uh-huh. 내가 왜 그랬을까 지금 후회를 하면서
right?
글을 쓰고 있습니다. Making promises when you're in a good mood, 기분이 좋을 때 약속을 하는 것은 is truly dangerous.
Yes.
정말로 위험합니다. 내가 yes. 왜 그랬지? Why did I say right? that? Why did I promise to paint the garage?
They probably knew how to get you in a good mood. You're so awesome. You're so helpful. And you're like, yeah, yeah I am. I'll do that.
I'll do everything you say.
right? Okay, so those are definitely some great and interesting social media posts, but that's the end of In the Social World, mm-hmm. and unfortunately, the end of the show, but just for today.
네, 저희는 다음 시간에 다시 돌아오겠습니다.
We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Don't you wanna be like us? Don't you wanna be like us?